Zoinks! Gulp.
Hey guys, welcome to Turek Dinosaur Hunter. I am your host, Mike Lott, and we're going to be playing this on probably hard. There's like hardcore as well. That's why I mentioned the difference between difficulties. The enemies become slightly harder, but the main bad thing about the difficulties is that the enemies drop way less ammo. On hardcore, they drop almost nothing, which means you got to run around with your knife all the time. I'm going to be running around a lot with my knife anyway, so picking on hard doesn't actually really bother me all that much. And also violence options, we can definitely want some red blood. There's actually a lot of options. This is basically a PC port of a old N64 game. And I knew about the N64 game of this, I had never played it, to be honest. And then I decided to pick up the PC version of this, and I just felt like... I've actually played this game on stream already, so I've already completed the game. And it was my first run. I've never played the N64 version. As I said, I'd never really owned a lot of consoles when I was younger. And so yeah, we gotta go find the hub. So here we had a fire. So we have a bow and we have a knife. And knifing is incredibly fun in this game. I was looking up YouTube videos of this game. And I noticed that someone I'm familiar with, Dark Shadow Rage, who was someone who participated in some of my Jedi Knight stuff. I recognize his name. I'm like, he's like the only major person who's done this besides I guess now. Well, I think there's like another person or two, but that was the person I recognized. Okay, and we just got our pistol, and it's been in a bit of a secret place. So. The game is like a bit of your classic, kind of like run a gun. After playing Doom, I kind of felt like playing another kind of classic fast-paced shooter. So we're looking for these little cube things, and we're gonna just hold it up in the air in the most manliest of ways. And there's 5 keys to find on this level. I've gotta catch them all, guys. But it's fine; they're not that hard to get. That's gonna open that guy. Yeah, I guess we just want to go that way. So we could try the bow out. Holy shit, this guy's fast. That's determination. Alright, anyway, so let's go to the fun. What? I got 2 health from what? From stabbing this guy? I had to stab this guy. Yeah, I get like 2 health from stabbing a deer. Who would have thought? And he just now vaporized. I thought I put red blood on. Oh, here we go. Alright, so here's a trick to knifing in this game. If you hit them square in the back, it's a one-hit kill, and I used to do it way better. Yeah, there you go, one-hit kill. There you go, one-hit kill. So you can play the entire game by just one-hitting killing everything. And I'm gonna shoot that guy because he's a what the hell? Who the hell is shooting me? So. Even like the biggest enemies in the game, you can actually one-hit knife. Oh, whoops. I'm being shot up by someone, and I don't know who. That guy, probably. There you go, one-hit kill. And it's actually a lot of fun, knifing people like that. Even that guy can get knifed, but he's actually the kind of guy we probably don't. We're picking up triangles, I guess, for some stupid reason. I actually don't know why. I completely forget. But it'll probably come to me. Probably for, like, extra lives or something. This is a live system. But it's a fast-paced game. I just had a hankering to play something like this again. Okay. I apparently cannot make that jump, but I think I can make it from over here. No, I can't. I think I'm just really terrible, then. We'll pick up some of this health, though. Fuck this guy. So we are Turok the Dinosaur Hunter, and we got another cube. Collecting cubes. Very, very video game heavy. And, the graphics don't exactly translate to what the N64 version was. Well, neither does the handling of the entire game, to be honest. I really want to make it up here. I just don't know how. Is there like a... Okay, I was thinking maybe there's another way of getting up there. Alright. Guy's dead. Maybe we get up there from here. Actually, I think we do get up there from here. I think I have auto run, don't I? Yeah, I do. So there's no sprinting or running or anything like that. It's very simple. So guys, can you imagine? This used to be an N64 game, and also that was the way I was supposed to make it up there. So I just kind of stopped in midair. If I hold both movement keys, I run slightly faster. So let's try and make it up there. By the way, I don't know where every secret is. I know where most of them are, but fuck me. It's probably gonna end up being things like this. There we go. Okay, so now we got more pizza slices. I'm gonna just keep calling them something different every time I see one. Alright, and we got another one right here. There's also some health here. I haven't played this in about a couple months, so maybe a little bit rusty. We could also go... Can we go down? Oh, no, that's a shadow. It looked like it went deep. Well, sorry, not a shadow. Why can't we open that? Okay, actually, that's a mystery we must solve here, right now. Why doesn't that door open? Actually, it's because there's a switch right there. Maybe we can make it up here. There we go. Alright, now that's opening. Yeah, they're slightly faster on hard difficulty, so we just have to be careful about that. And we have our first checkpoint here. And, oh, we got some pizza slices right here. So we got, this is like Aztec ruins kind of thing, and that guy's gonna lob a grenade at me, fucking dick. Now, if you haven't noticed, I haven't actually picked up an incredible amount of ammo for the bow. Just one of those things I have to deal with. Alright, we can also go into the Stargate here. We also get a new weapon here. This is like a secret, like, platform in place. It's kind of weird. I don't quite get the point of this, but... We'll explore it. Fortunately, falling doesn't actually drain your health, but this should give you a drone. Oh shit, what's this guy want? Okay. I kind of didn't want what he was sawing. Alright, I don't think there's anything up there. Although there's some ammo over there, so we're gonna jump over here anyways. Or what the hell is this anyways? That's a backpack. Okay. So now we have all our camping supplies, so we can last in the outback for a little while. Now we're not knifing those guys, because as much of a baller as we are as the Turok man, I don't like platforming being shut up at the same time. I guess we'll head down here. And yes, this game has a fair bit of platforming, and it hits you like a brick wall. It's a lot of bad platforming, actually. Alright, we got our shotgun shells. We can try our new weapon for all but 30 seconds, and then we'll probably head back to the knife. Oh, dude, it's a dinosaur. Okay, I wasted 5 shots on that. Okay, he died pretty hard there. Alright, here's another shotgun. In case you didn't want to go through the platforming maze of death. And we've got some clips here. Actually, the ammo isn't so bad right now. But we still will be knifing a lot anyways. Mostly because of fun. So, there's only one, like, bonus area per level. Get out of here, you stupid boar. So there's, like, one bonus area per level. Oh shit, okay, I fell down here by accident. So remember, it took me 5 shotgun shells to kill this dinosaur, right? Alright, now... Fuck, I'm not finding a sweet spot. Basically, you want to stuff the knife right up his asshole, and then, yeah, it kills him one hit. Fuck, there you go. That's the sweet spot. Like, that one took 4, but it was because, as I said, I found the one hit sweet spot. 1, 2, there you go. I actually have a crazy amount of fun with this. Alright, here we got a bit more platforming. It looks like if we make it to the, if we get into that water, it actually won't matter, but I don't know, it doesn't look dangerous. Oh yeah, we'd have to climb. Okay, we'd get annoyed because we'd have to climb back up there. Mind you, later on the game, that would be instant death. Wow, there's a lot of this shit. Well, at least there's some health here. That's fine. I'm actually glad they made a port of this to the PC, because it's one of those games I've always wanted to try, but I've never wanted to play it with a controller. And I imagine a lot of what I'm doing right now with regards to stabbing things in the back is probably not something you would really do in the N64 version of the game. Okay. I think I missed one block of cheese. I think I missed two blocks of cheese. Oops. Can I just climb up here? Fuck. I can't make it up there. Oh, look, we finally got some arrows. Alright, here we have a new enemy, and he's slightly mad at me. But don't worry. If you find the sweet spot, right up his butthole, he does in one hit, so it's all good. It's a very narrow thing. It's like you're playing the spy in TF2, but it's a very narrow thing of focus. So basically like the spy in TF2 in every way. But I think I may be changing the difficulty at some point, because as I said, this may get kind of annoying with the amount of ammunition and health it decides to give me. Alright, no, fuck you, dinosaur. See, you see how long it's taking me? It's because I haven't hit him in the butt. Now I hit him in the butt. But, and he also works with monkeys. No, oh, get piece of shit. Shit, whatever. Oh fuck, that one blew up. All right, I think I have the new kind of arrows that blow up now. Those are the tech arrows. They blow up instead of just rather like not blowing things up. Fuck. What the fuck? Dude, this is not the place you want to be running. All right, let's run over here. We have a checkpoint there. Well, we'll shoot these guys. Okay, so we have two routes we can take. I'm gonna take this way. Seems like the route less traveled. We got 30 arrows and that's it. Yeah, so tech arrows are the blowing up ones. Just remember that, guys. All right, so that's a pit of death. But we'll pick up the pizza slice on the rear side of it. Dude, the guy ran up to me to try and, like, hit me with his shotgun. What a baller. Alright, so we have lava here. And does lava kill you is the question? It probably does. Also, that place back there was a safe place, and I totally didn't touch it. Whatever, we don't need it. This is a no-save run, by the way. No, I'm just joking. I'm gonna save, but I just forgot to. But I think I'll live, so it's fine. Here we have, actually, we were in this area. But now we have another dinosaur here. Fuck, we got explosive shells, though. And what are we gonna do with the ammunition we have? Completely not use it. Fine, you wanna see it? Here. Oh, look, it blows up. Who would've thought? But knife is still more effective. Did we were out here? Yeah, we were out here. Oh shit, you know what? These guys actually hurt. How are you fucking choking to death on grenades? That's the real question. Alright, let's go down here, because there's actually some shit down here, so I'm pretty sure this is where you go. Okay, here you go, extra life. We got 3 lives now, I guess. And this brings us pretty much right back to, I think that, remember, it's once per level that those portals actually mean anything. I'll just demonstrate it. Oh, actually, never mind. It's not once per level. All right, I have absolutely no idea how it works then. A good thing I actually checked, but I mean they don't really do anything other than like, oh, they're like little trap rooms kind of thing. Fuck it. Fuck, I got hit. Whatever, we've got health now. I was doing so well, too. Oh man. Now, if you decide that you don't want to do this area, I think you're kind of forced to go through it, if I remember. I don't think you have a choice. But you just have to kind of go back to where, because usually what the portal will be is like the portal back is it like probably at the beginning usually. But sometimes it's not, if I recall. Yeah, see, there's the portal back. It was the one I came in through. So we got we got ultra health actually. So this is totally worth, even though I got hit by something. All right. So I may not be 100% aware of how everything works in this game, but just know that there's gonna be a lot of stabby action in this game. I never grew up with the game, so I can't give you that kind of perspective. I assume that a lot of the mechanics in this game are, I guess, geared towards the rental market because they wanted you to buy the game. So oftentimes what they would do in games like this was they would make things extremely difficult, so it would take you a very long time to beat the game, essentially, so. Fuck these guys. Alright, got another block of cheese. And we got a level 2 key. You're gonna figure out what these things are for in a little bit, guys. Right now it's a secret and I will not tell you. Nah, just know we're picking up cubes for no fucking reason whatsoever. Oh no, it's this guy. Whatever will we do? Probably stab in the back. Right up his butthole. There you go, we found the spot. That one's like a 1 degree kind of radius though. But all it is just essentially circle scraping. And it works on almost everything. I think just bosses it doesn't work on. Get the fuck out of here. This is actually the funnest way to play this game. Because it makes it extremely fast-paced. Whoa. Because it's also about, like, avoiding the damage that these enemies would normally give you. Alright, let this guy come over here. No! There you go. Alright, there's a red one. And he died in one hit. Oh, three hits. Honestly, these yellow ones have given me more of a trouble than that big red one has. So this is like a portal, I think. Yeah, it probably is. Alright, let's go into it. Where'd we go out to? Oh no, dinosaurs. Oh, you motherfucker. You can have some too. Okay, well, I think he died by normal knife hits. But eventually those guys may... They may cause more of a problem for me. What the hell is this thing? Oh, dude, I think this is where I get high as fuck. Yeah, there you go. Spiritual invincibility. Oh shit, everything's like slow motion. Fuck you, boar. Let's see if I can one hit this guy. There you go, one hit. Oh, two hit. I feel like Neo right now. Three one hit. It's fucking great. Now you can say you watched a guy on YouTube run around and knife dinosaurs. And honestly, your life is now complete, guys. It's kind of fulfilling. Alright, I missed a bunch of shit back here, I'm assuming, so there's nothing really down there. Because there's so much parkouring to be done in a game like this. Okay, apparently I cannot jump onto there. The game's racist. Because I'm Native American. Actually, I don't even know if I'm American or Native. All I know is I look like some... tribal dude. So... Take from it as what you will. You can have your theories of what he is. Okay, I guess there really isn't anything here. Oh wait, there's some health here actually. That's worth picking up. Okay, totally worth coming back here for. You never know when you may need it. Now the enemies don't drop health, they just simply drop ammo, but it looks like we're basically full on pistol ammo anyways. But we're having so much fun with a knife that fuck it. Like, I could basically spend about, like, 20 minutes plugging that guy full of, like, pea shooter bullets. Or I could just knife him once in the ass, and then it's much more fun that way. So, this is how we play video games, guys. Okay, maybe that guy was worth plugging the ass. Well, no, sorry, plugging full of bullets, but whatever. Not plugging the ass. Let's try it out. Oh no, three. Yeah, okay, that guy, he's worth using the ammunition on. Maybe this guy too. Okay, actually, we don't want to go back here yet, so. Actually, wait, what are we doing? Oh, that's a lot of beetles. Also, I'm pretty sure these things are respawning right now, which is something else that this difficulty will do. It was a makeshift spawn. But, just shoot these guys. Actually, we can't, because, there's an invisible wall here. So, it looks like we're kind of shit out of luck, and we're gonna have to do things the normal way. Which is, climbing up the ladder. Apparently, climbing ladders is a very strenuous activity. Don't try it at home, guys. I'm not going down for this guy. I mean, there's really no point in me killing everything if it's not an area I'm not going to come back to, but whatever. Alright. Okay, can we stab beetles is the real question. Yeah, they actually die really easily. Not even worth using ammunition on. Okay, maybe this guy was worth using ammunition on. Yeah, Mike Black does not die to beetles. Alright, we got a puddle here. And this is a, I guess it, is that like a mega health thing? No, it's just a regular health thing. I think that's like an extra bonus, kind of like, if you're really missing a lot of health, it'll just give you a shit ton. But the knife will be your favorite weapon for this entire game, if you're me. You know, I'm really weird with my taste, because half the time I'll be like, fuck, railguns and everything. Like, I want railguns in my breakfast cereal, I want it in everything. And then, in this particular game, I'm just kind of like, oh, I would rather run around with a knife. Alright, so we have this little portal guy here, but let's see what's down here first. Fuck. I can't predict where he'll go. Okay, let's just see where this goes. Okay, let's go back. Because I'm pretty sure that's the way forward. I think this is another secret passageway. Because remember, this is below one of the raptors that we saw earlier. And we see, oh, we got an assault rifle, guys. Alright, we will proceed not to use that weapon. No, it's actually a better use of our bullets. I think it uses the same ammunition. So let's see. There we go. It's actually bound to the same key, which is actually super convenient. So yeah, it is on the same key, and it's just an assault rifle. Alright, we'll use this for a couple seconds. Just so you guys get the hang of it. It's like a AK-47. It actually just burst fires it. Is there something other than beetles we can kind of shoot at, or no? Fuck, like, the knife is better. Why do we even bother, guys? Alright, we'll go here. There was another path we passed up earlier, but we'll go back to that guy soon. Okay, the minute I see something... Oh, here we go. Alright, that's your assault rifle. It's actually not a bad weapon, I have to say. You know what's better than that? A knife. Alright, we missed like a shit ton of stuff. So, we're gonna kind of look around here. What? Okay. Oh, okay. I didn't know, I wasn't aware this was what he was guarding. I just came out of the brush and I just kind of fucked him up. Alright, you know, fuck these guys. Alright, this guy can die to knife. What the fuck you just do to me? Fucking bitch. Okay, I'm pretty sure we missed something else a while back here. So let's just keep going. There's like a little path. Yeah, see right here? Yeah, there you go. We would miss all this important ammo that we're probably not going to use. Yeah, look at all that. Oh, yeah. Explosive shells, guys. Guys, if we don't pick this up, then how will we become completionist? And here we have a clip and... is that actually a clip? That's not actually a clip. Suddenly, thousands of fucking gun enthusiasts were triggered. Not a clip. But that's okay. Because we can suspend our disbelief because this guy's a Native American. And he doesn't know any better, clearly. Alright, I don't know if he's... I still don't know if he's Native American. Alright. Fuck this guy up. Guy who ran up. Okay, I'm pretty sure there's like a secret in this area, but I don't care. There's probably just something else I'm not gonna use, so... We got a checkpoint, so that's okay. Fuck you doing? It's like throwing out the fucking wall. Wow, we have like 55 health now. We are not doing good on hard right now, guys. Basically, I'm gonna start probably shooting the shit that's actually shooting me. Although these things are really easy to kill anyways. So first level, and we found like, what, 4 weapons? Yeah, so we're off to a good start. Oh, would you... You teleporting in here? Let me give you permission to do things like that. Technology is reserved for enthusiasts only. Alright. Fuck out of here. Let's see if I can jump to this. Of course I can. Oh, fuck. Alright. Looks like he wants some mortal knife combat. Alright, it looks like he will not let me hit his backside. So we probably should do something else. Oh, here we go. Alright, maybe we'll fucking not do that. Alright. We actually do not want to go back here quite yet. Yeah, it's a long way down. By the way, we totally found the hub, but I'm pretty sure there's other shit we're supposed to get first. I think I just, like, sequence broke the game here. Wait, what the fuck? Where did we start at? Get the fuck out of here, dinosaur. If I wanted an opinion of a velociraptor with a weird helmet on it. Or no, that's not a helmet, that's like a... it's like its nose. Okay. Well, he's a bit nosy, if you ask me. Yeah. Alright, let me get the fuck back to where I was, because, yeah. I'm pretty sure I missed a fuck ton of shit. Yeah, fuck you too. Alright, guys, we made it back. And, yeah, we would have missed this. There's no fall damage, by the way. So, we wanted to climb into the pit. And see all the pillars, guys. And the waterfall. Dude, it's just beautiful. Let's just stay here and see the... Kind of look at the nice black sky. And stab some fucking beetles. Let's go into the waterfall, because everyone knows that there's always secrets in waterfalls. Alright. That apparently would not be the case in this game. Ah, oh, dude, he actually hit me. Alright, well. Guys, I have to uninstall Turok because it was a shame. It brings too much shame to me. Fuck, and I fell. That beetle just outplayed me. Looks like I have to go, like, all the way back. No! Can I fucking go back? Yeah. I can't jump that high. Actually, this goes actually deeper than this. Oh! Health here, guys. 25 health. That's a lot of health. Just kind of explore. Alright, I think we're done. Alright, looks like that's it for that. Now, platform up here. And up! What do we have here? See, this is what we would have missed. This is what we would have missed if I didn't fucking come back. And all keys on this level found. And it places us right in front of this guy. And congratulations, guys, we did it. Welcome to the hub world. Or as I like to call it, City 17. Alright. So here, we have to... this is level 6. So these are basically your levels. Oh, look, I can access level 3. This is level 5. Have nothing for that. Level 7. This is what we've been collecting this whole time. Oh, level 2 is now open because we got all the things for that. Level 4. I guess level 1 is what we just did, so... I don't know if there's like a map or something I can press. I don't know. I think there is. Oh, keys. Here we go. You can see your keys right here. So there's a little icon here. I think I missed that somewhere. I should probably have a look at that. But also there's a save point here. I obviously have played this game before. So let's just make like 2 saves. Actually, I can kind of tell by it. The last time I played this was December, so there you go. That's how long it's been since I played this last. I'm gonna figure out where that crazy 8 thing is. Alright guys, we're back in the maze. And I figured out that the our nice little secret is somewhere actually in the maze, so we're gonna just spend a couple of minutes over here having a look around. And we wanna find the secret, by the way. So we're gonna have a good look around to see what I missed. I thought it was something else, but apparently it wasn't. It wasn't what the secret was, so. So have a look over here. No, not this way. There's an enemy over there because they like to respawn. Actually, could be this way. Could very well be this way. That would be the way forward. And we're not going to have any of that, guys. Oh, there it is. And there's your secret area. So it's a slice of something. So we pick it up. It's a Chrono Scepter piece. What does that do? Well, we don't know. Well, I guess we'll figure it out by when we collect them all, guys. It's like playing a Mario game. It's the stars, so or something like that. Well, we're gonna go figure out what that does by the end of the game. But we're just gonna now go right back to the hub world because I gotta go through the rest of this. All right, guys. It looks like I made it back to the hub world. So that's all the time we got for today. Next time we'll go to level 2. See y'all later. Peace out.